we will end with this last line. Further deposit taking and systematically important NBFCs have to maintain a minimum capital adequacy ratio of 15% of their aggregate risk-weighted assets. Oh my God, there are too many new terms in this. Okay, so just be with me. What is it that's trying to say? It says that deposit taking and systematically important NBFCs. What are deposit taking NBFCs? Of course, NBFCs which are taking deposits. Deposits from anywhere, be it other banks, be it people. It is not their own money. These are deposits that have been taken from various other places. So that is a deposit taking NBFC. A deposit taking NBFC or a systemically important NBFC. What is a systemically important NBFC? It is important to the system. So if this particular NBFC does fail, it'll have ripples on the economy. So, well, of course, because of its scope, because of its lending capacity, because of the number of people associated with it, these kind of NBFCs have to tend to have a greater impact on society in case the economy takes a downturn, in case of a recession or anything that goes wrong with the economy. These NBFCs will be the first ones that could create the ripples and could have a larger impact on the economy or bring them down. So if it is a systemically important NBFC, if it is important to the system, and if it is taking deposits from the people, of course it has to have greater regulation on it, and hence it does. So that's why the RBI says that in that case, you have to maintain some amount of money, which is the 15% of all the risk weighted assets that you have. So all the assets which are risky in nature, of course, all of this is assessed, then 15% of that, of the total number of risk weighted assets that you have, is going to be the minimum amount of money that you're actually going to maintain, and the minimum amount of capital that you are going to maintain. So you can't just lend out everything. So what happens is, in case if there is some sort of a downturn or an anomaly, then at least we can depend upon that 15% amount, which is the minimum capital adequacy ratio. Obviously, if you have a greater amount of capital adequacy ratio, then you have a greater capacity to deal with any sort of problems that hit the economy. But in this case, it's 15, which I think is fairly decent and is a fair amount of money that is good enough for any NBFC to deal with, you know, some sort of economic downturn that might hit it. Okay, so on that note, guys, this is what the article says. I think we've learned a lot of new factors and a lot of new points, and we hope this session was quite useful to you. We hope you've understood a little bit more about how NBFCs operate. You've understood about why it is got a lot less regulation in comparison to banks. You've understood why it has a higher amount of interest rate when it is lending to people that reach out to an NBFC. And I'm sure you finally understood the crux of the article, which forms its headline, as to why we need to have a greater amount of regulation right now, given the COVID situation and given how NBFCs had overstepped their boundaries, gone ahead and lent it to so many people which may not return the money, and eventually that could create ripples in the economy as well as, you know, in the entire financial sector. So all of this put together, guys, it is important that we now support a greater amount of regulation to be put for the NBFC. We will come back with more such sessions like this, and we will understand and read more news articles in our next video. But until then, I hope you can avoid newspapers, because hey, you don't have to be prepared to be able to attend these sessions, and you can just be mentally geared up to see each of these videos. So that's all that you need to do, is stay away from newspapers, because we are going to do all the spoon feeding that you need. Don't stress about what the terms and, you know, terminologies are. If you want, you can quickly take a look at this article and go over the article that has been mentioned. Feel free to post questions in the comments below, or even write to us at our in the message section of this particular handle. So I'm hoping to hear a lot from you guys, and thank you so much for joining in this session. It was an absolute pleasure. Hope to see you soon. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Do you read newspapers? We didn't think so either. What if you had an expert from every field to explain ideas and topics from their domain in a matter that is so simple that even a 10-year-old can learn just as easily as any of you adult heads? Well, here's introducing Smarticles by Reading Right. Smart news articles explained by rigorously well-read field experts. After a careful selection, these articles have been made available to you in its original form from the only hand-picked Wordly publications, while the explanations are inserted on it using an unmatched technology. So now, you can learn word meanings, understand a concept, or get detailed text and video explanations to any line in the article just by a simple tap right there. And we guarantee that you will never feel lost about any topic anymore, even if you don't read newspapers at all. Get ready to smart, only with Reading Right. Statutory warning, not everyone can handle this level of smart. So log on to web.readingright.in or download the Reading Right app from Play Store or App Store at your own risk.